Hi Cubies, here's your Alexandra and welcome to another painting tutorial. Today we are tackling a Dread Scythe Harridan from the Nighthaunts. I have built her already, as you can see. But on these models there's always one thing that bothers me very heavy, and that's the reason why I haven't painted a single one of them already, and that's those scythe hands. Those I find this concept totally stupid, absolutely stupid. And well, for the longest time I have been looking for a way to fix that, and I think I have found the solution. Here, I have bothered my bit seller on eBay for some bits, and what do we have here? Those are the weapon arms of Dark Elf Witch Elves. Knives and swords, and well, let's have a look at them and see what we can do with them to fix the problem. So, spread them out a little bit and search for some fitting ones. So we need a right arm and a left arm. So for the right and the left, let's take this one for the left and this one here for the right arm. Okay, so let's see. For a good fit, I would say we cut like there, directly at the shoulder pad, and attach it there, like that. And for this arm here, yeah, we will cut it like that and attach it there. Yeah, that's what we will do. So let's simply cut off this arm. I will cut it directly here at the rope so that we have a nice gluing point. If we would cut the arm, for example, here, the gluing point would be very, very narrow and would lead to more and more breaking of the arm. So let's clean the cut a little bit. Make sure when you're handling an X-Acto knife that you always hold your knife like that so that you can't cut yourself. You see, your thumb is resting here on this plastic part of the knife, and so you can't actually cut yourself. Obviously, when you are cutting away from you, that's not an issue. So, yeah, that's nice and clean. So, and now let's take a look at the arm here. Let's first clean the cut. That side, let's just clip it. There we go. Clean the mold line off. There we go. There's a mold line. Now let's cut right here, like that. Yeah, that's a nice clean straight edge where we can nicely glue it to the miniature. Number one, and here we have number two. Let's also clean that up. Like that, and like that. And also here. And here you can see there's a little step in there, and let's just use that as a cutting point. There we have it. Okay, time to glue this stuff together, shall we? So, let's take our glue. Simple normal plastic glue. One there. One there, and then we'll attach it . So let's adjust it a little. So it looks natural, and I would say, yeah, it's a nice fit. And on the other side, maybe. So, ta-da! And there we have a new and improved Dread Scythe Harridan. So, I let the glue now dry completely for about 2 hours, and then I will prime her, and then I'll be back for the painting. Be right back. So, Tubies, as you can see, I have primed her, and now is the time to start painting. The first coat I will apply is here Deep Blue from Scale 75. But every really dark blue will do the trick. Like Deadly Nightshade or something like that. You see this nice deep Prussian blue we have here. So, I will cover the entire lower part with that. And also the hair. This is a pretty easy step, and I'll be back when this is done. So, Tubies, there I'm back, and as you can see, the blue is now applied in a nice and even coat. To achieve this, I have simply painted 2 thin coats, and ta-da, it is done. So, now we take here our sky blue. And we want to wet blend the whole thing, so on our palette we mix it with a Prussian blue, here with a deep blue to make a mid-tone. Yeah, something along that line. That's good. Some water in it. There we go, and that would simply be applied as a middle layer. Just like that. to have a ground base to work from the wet blending. So also on the inside. There we go. It doesn't need to be perfect in the coverage, just so we have a base to work with. Because acrylic paints are transparent in their nature, if we were to wet blend on this dark surface, the farther we go down, the harder it will get a good coverage, because well, the dark will always shine through. Yeah. So to avoid this, we pre-paint that in that color. So then we take the pure sky blue, and make it farther down the line, like that. And quickly establish that color. Yeah, there we go. And that needs to dry now. Be right back. So, and now I show you how I tackle the wet blending. So, we have on our palette directly ready all three colors, slightly watered down. And I will start applying here the Prussian blue, just like that. Then I will quickly grab the mid-tone and paint it like that, and start working it together here in the middle, wiping off the brush real quick, and with a soft and dry brush we will mix the colors directly here on the miniature. Take a little bit of the mid-tone again, a little bit of the dark, and blending it together until we have a color transition that we are satisfied with. So same goes for down there. We take our brighter color, apply it here, and then we'll start mixing it directly with the mid-tone. Again, taking a little bit of the mid-tone here and dabbing it down here. Again, some of the brighter color, until we have a nice transition here in the middle. Just like that. You always go back and forth, until you're satisfied with the result. That's how it is done. So, I will finish that up now, and, well, we see us in a second. So tubies, this is how it looks now, with a nice wet blend. And now we will tackle the hair, and for that I want her to have brighter hair than the actual cloth, and for that I will start applying the sky blue we had previously as the first layer, and I will slightly go on the edges, leave a little bit of the dark obviously behind, but I will simply paint the hair strands now, like this. a tiny little bit of water on the brush to get the flow a little bit better if you see the paint cracking while you apply it. That's something that you get over time when you are painting miniatures. You get a feel for the paint itself, how moist and how thick you want the paint to be, how it needs to be. That's something that I cannot really teach you guys. I always get the question, how many water do I put into my paint? One drop, two drops, or three drops? That's nothing I can really say to you, because every paint bottle is different, has a different amount of water. You had laying it open for different amounts of time, evaporation, and so on. And the humidity in the air around your painting space is different. And so this is just something that you need to learn over time. You learn over time to get a feel for your paint, and this is something that you will get only by painting a lot. There's a little trick to get a good amount of painting done, and the thing is, paint every day. I know it sounds a lot, but at least try it out. Sit every day down for at least maybe 1 minute, and do at least one paint stroke on a miniature. Or paint a tiny little portion of a miniature. For example, yeah, paint the hairs of one miniature in one solid color. Even if you don't have much time, a little bit of time everybody can spare. And so over time you get a feeling for the paint. You get the muscle memory for working with paint. And over time you will develop the right feeling how to handle your paints. And specifically your paints, because every new bottle is a new challenge for you. It will get easier with time, because you don't have to adjust that much anymore, because you have experience, you know? So, and I think this is good for the first hairline, and now we will add some white to it. Mixing it good up. A little bit water in it, just for good measure. And then I'll go over it again. And obviously leave a little bit of the old color behind. And try to concentrate more on the upper parts of the miniature. Don't go too much into detail. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. A little bit highlight here, a little bit highlight there. Just feel the paint, and the miniature itself will tell you where the highlights should go. Just let the brush be an extension of your fingers, your eyes, and play around with the paint. Paint is a toy, so use it. Now we need a little bit more white. Do the next highlight. A little bit more water. You get the feel. Maybe you ask yourself, why didn't you do this with a simple dry brush? Well, the thing is, if you dry brush something, it will have always a chalky look to it. so-called dry brushed look. And since we had here a wet blending on the miniature, I feel a dry brush look wouldn't look good on this miniature. So I'm going for the step-by-step highlight. So now even more white and even more water. There we go. Nice sky blue now. And then we have a little tiny little hair sticking out that we can pull out. So, and guys, I really like my Discord server, and people are sharing their painted miniatures with me. But guys, we have many people here watching this channel who are not on the Discord server, and I still want to see your miniatures, the stuff that you produce here, following my tutorials, and I would really, really like you guys to show me your work. And well, to do that, there's also a nice way if you use Instagram. Well, just use the hashtag GPTutorial, and well, then I can see your work that you have done following one of my tutorials. Wouldn't that be neat? So, hashtag GPTutorial. So, and we are almost done with the hair. Now the final highlight, almost pure white. Just at the ends here. A bit here. A little bit there. And there we go. I think the hair looks nice now. Yeah. So next part will be the roses, and in between takes I will simply paint the base, this little rock structure here, and the back part here in black. So, and also the gloves that the Haridan is having on. So, be right back. And I'm back, and as you can see, the black is applied. Here is still a little bit wet down there, but that doesn't matter right now. So, the next step is we'll apply a tiny little bit of Acrux Earthshade. So, just taking the brush here. Dum-de-dum. And we'll apply that to the skull face. To give it this nice bone texture feeling. Don't worry, we'll highlight this also later. But right now, just a coat of wash will do. Okay, also I will apply that here to the fingers. There we go. A little bit more, maybe. And also here. Where we have a tiny little bit of skin showing through. We need a little bit more on the face. Yeah, that should do it. That should do it. It's a little bit out of focus. Sorry for that. So, and the next step is we will prime the roses that are in the hair with white. And no, actually, for that I will use here Wraith Bone from GW. Because it has a better coverage ability than actual white. It has a little higher pigment count. So this should work better. And we will simply pick out each and every single rose that we have in the air. After this is dry, we will apply some contrast paints to them to simply give them some color. Yeah, I will finish up painting the roses and be right back. Yeah, the roses are now dry and it's time to give them some red with Blood Angels Red contrast paint. So let's quickly grab that and apply it. Make sure that you don't overly touch the blue. And you're good to go. Just like that. So, number three. I have a little bit too much contrast paint on the brush right now. I'll remove a little bit. There you see what I mean. I have to suck it up. Yeah, fixed. Wonderful. We want the right amount. Exactly that amount that we can see shadows and highlights on the roses. That would be too much. So, ta-da! The roses are painted. Now, I'm going to prime the blades. I want them to be really rusty. And for that, I'm using a dark brown. In this case, I'm using rhinoxide. Give it a good undercoat with a thin layer. You see that the color is quite watery when you can actually see some white edges here. This color is thin, so when it dries out it won't overburden the miniature with paint. Because nothing is worse than painting with too thick paint and covering details, covering them up, clogging them with too much paint. Yeah, this needs to dry now. Be right back. Okie dokie, it is time to work on the bone parts. And for that, we use Rockhearth Flash. We don't need a whole lot of that, just a little bit. So, let's paint the face. Make it nice and even. And if you hear licking sounds, that's right there. There, I have a cat. Yep. That's that. So, she's definitely helping here, keeping me sane. I'm recording this video at 5 a.m. in the morning right now. That's because my landlord is renovating my building. Since the start of the year, they are tearing this entire building apart and building it back up, and I have construction noises around the clock, so it is for me impossible to record a video during the daytime. So for me it is recording in the middle of the night. So now we will mix in some of the wraith bone. Making roughly a 50-50 mix. And with that, we will start to pick out the raised details on the skull. Just like that, a little bit here, a little bit there, highlighting the fingers. Okay, now I go for pure wraith bone. And as you can see, the more and more we highlight this, the more three-dimensional this face becomes. So, and last but not least, I will go for some white. For the absolute top highlights. There we go. And a little bit there. Okay. Yeah, that's the bone parts done. So now let's paint the daggers. And for that, I'm gonna take a very small dry brush with some metal paint. Quickly give it some strokes here and there. To give it a little bit of a metal sheen. There we go. Then we take some Mournfang Brown. A blob of water on my brush here on the metal part. Stipple a little, tiny little bit of the brown here at the base. This is where the main rust area should be. So now I go for, oops. Something has fallen. That's not good. We go for two oranges here from Vallejo Game Color, Fiery Orange and Hot Orange. And first some Hot Orange. So I make a little mixture, a little bit with a Bessie Brown, Mournfang Brown, sorry, and I will stipple that like here, a little bit there. Now I go for a pure hot orange. And this goes here, right in the middle. Just like that. Now, for the last part, some of the orange fire. Just a tiny little amount here and there. It's like the most intense rust. If you look at rust in real life, it is always a mixture out of dark browns, oranges, and tiny bit of metal. So, voila, I have nice rusty blades. Yeah, that's that. I think I will give here in the middle of the metal, another bit of orange, there we go. Yeah, that's better. Okay, I will go ahead and finish the base. This is just a little bit of dry brushing. And yeah, then I can call it quits. The miniature is done. Normally, there are some vines here in the roses in the hair. I could paint them in green, but should I? Yeah, I will quickly do that. Let's pick up a green. We have here now a Slimer green from a scale color. This is from the fantasy range. It's the other colors are all super matte. The fantasy range is normal glossy, like every other acrylic paint, like from Games Workshop or Vallejo or what have you. So let's pick out the vines here. There we go. Now on the other side, this is a vine. Yeah, and I think that's done. Let's say that this is. It's also a vine. Like that. Okie dokie. What else is to do? Maybe some highlights here in gray on the on the black part to differentiate that a little bit more. So let's quickly grab a gray. And paint in some highlights. Pick out the raised areas, the folds, maybe here, down at the bottom. Don't totally overdo it, otherwise the black won't look as black anymore, but just gray. And we don't want that. We still want to have it black. So, now a little bit more white in it. Make it a warm gray here with some wraith bone instead of white. So, and there we have some highlights on that. Yeah, that should do it. And that's basically how to paint a Dread-Scythe Harridan. I will finish up the base now and show you the end result in a second. Be right back. Yeah, Tubies, here we have as you can see, I have
before we sit down to hobby, we should fuel up on something nutritious. I recommend eggs. Eggs will keep us filled up and painting for hours on end. And there are so many tasty ways to make them.